When I first started learning UniRx, I really liked the idea of working with data streams. But to be honest, I didn't really understand how to create them. And I spent way more time than I care to admit using the create operator to make all of my observables from scratch. The create operator allows you to define your own custom data streams by giving you access to the observer. Calling onNext, onError, and onComplete on the observer invokes the delegate methods that you pass in when you subscribe to the resulting observable. Experimenting with the create operator is a great exercise because it gives you a look at what's going on under the hood when you create observables using UniRx's built-in creation operators. But you don't really want to use the create operator unless you need to roll out your own custom solution. UniRx comes with plenty of ways to create observables right out of the box. The most common way is to use Monobehaviour Triggers. UniRx provides the ability to create observables for Monobehaviour events. All you need to do is add the UniRx.triggers namespace to your script. You'll get access to a long list of triggers, as well as game object and Monobehaviour extension methods that make it really easy to create and subscribe to these special data streams. You can even create your own custom triggers by overriding Observable Trigger Base. Another way to create observables in UniRx is to convert coroutines into data streams. This can be done via the static fromCoroutine method, or by calling toObservable on a method that returns an IEnumerator. Coroutines are Unity's solution to writing asynchronous code, but they can't return values and don't support exception handling. Converting your coroutines into observables not only makes them compatible with the powerful tools that come with reactive extensions, but also solves these inherent issues. This example implements a countdown as a coroutine. The overloaded fromCoroutine method takes a delegate that exposes the observer, which we can use to not only return values, but also throw exceptions that can be handled by the subscriber. On the flip side, you can actually use observables as yield instructions in your coroutines. All you need to do is call toYield instruction on any observable. This enables you to yield to complex scenarios in a declarative way, as opposed to filling your coroutines with monolithic and stateful conditional logic. And using this method, you can even yield to network operations. Speaking of which, UniRx also comes with a nice way to create observables from HTTP requests. The static ObservableWWW class provides methods for creating GET and POST requests as observables. These request streams can be canceled by using the dispose method and progress tracked via the schedule notifier class. And of course, as with all observables, you can come up with some pretty clever ways to compose and transform your request streams using the full power of reactive extensions. The last operators we'll cover in this video are frame count based time operators. They allow you to create observables that can be configured to emit on any number of specific frames. Some variations include emissions on every update, every n frames, or after a specified number of frames. Under the hood, frame count-based time operators use micro coroutines, which are memory-efficient and fast coroutine workers that are included specifically with UniRx. I definitely recommend checking out the documentation to learn more about this unique feature. All of the creation operators mentioned in this video come with UniRx and were made specifically for Unity. But there are actually a set of vanilla creation operators that come with every implementation of reactive extensions. You can learn more about those operators from the ReactiveX documentation that's linked in the description of this video. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and a comment letting me know what you thought. And for more content just like this, please consider subscribing with notifications on. Huge thank you to all my patrons, and a special shout out to Yakov and Dilyo.